Hey all, welcome back to Amp 3. I'm Incetic. With me again is Blank Tester.
Hey kids, how's it going?
And Turo.
Yes.
We got that drip check, of course, and look, I'm gold, baby. Yeah.
Whoa, you're golden.
You look like you're doing Kid Rock cosplay.
Yeah. And that's because we're finishing up Amp 3. We're heading to the final area, the DC Mountain Lab.
Debbie.
This is a pretty interesting area. It's once again just going to be, you know, one little area, but I think that's fine because this is based off of
a real place.
Yeah, the DC Mountain Lab was actually a private snow park owned by the co-founder of DC Shoes, Ken Block.
So
you could check up what the, you know, DC Mountain Lab that he, you know, built on this private property looked like in the DC Mountain Lab 2005 snowboarding movie. It's about a half hour long, and you'll see that it is actually pretty faithful. Like, of course, a lot of these set pieces and such have been really scaled up,
to make it work.
The game. But, you know, a short ride down this kind of area and then this sort of ending half pipe area at the road, because that's probably where the property boundary was.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then you just sort of continue on.
Yeah, Amp 3 adds a little extra afterwards, but yeah, it's a nice little additional area, and sure, again, if you're only trying to do the story, you spawn here, literally just ride down to the ending thing, and you could do the ending, but again, I'm going to do show this place off a lot else.
Right. You're going to do what the game doesn't want you to do and enjoy the content that they placed here.
You think? I mean, I don't know. I think they probably meant for you to play the game.
Potentially.
Right.
And then you just go into the woods and no one ever sees you again.
Yep, that's it. You ride off into the sunset ?
Yep. I mean, again, I think let's try and be kind of, you know, positive here.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I do like this game.
But? I also like the music. There.
Yeah. There you go. Video game.
How could you be positive twice?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
How
can one person have more than one good thing to say about any piece of art?
They do have some interesting rewards as part of doing, you know, some of the challenges here, like at the very end.
Oh my god!
I'll say that. Oh. We'll get to that as this goes along.
Yeah.
But yeah, so this was private, you know, land owned by Ken Block, operated from like 2005 to 2011, but this does not exist anymore, actually. So it being here in Amp 3 is sort of a time capsule.
That's cool.
Thanks, Ken.
Actually,
I'm gonna assume it wasn't his fault.
Yeah, they just removed the mountain from real life.
Oh, they went into the mountain.obj file and
and just removed it.
Yep. Thanks,
it
God.
Happened. Yeah. Oops.
You didn't have a backup.
Yeah.
Hard drive crash.
Yeah, what a moron.
Could you imagine if God's hard drive crashed?
You know what? That would be... I can't imagine it, and I wouldn't be there to imagine it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We are all just bits of data waiting to be blinked out of existence.
Yo, there's a guy at work who believes that.
Oh.
Like, he genuinely believes we're like all in a video game, and that quantum mechanics proves that when no one's looking at the moon doesn't exist.
Oh.
And that.
What?
Yeah, like, he seemed real smart for the first week and a half I was working there. And then he started talking about how, like, quantum mechanics says that when you close your eyes and no one's looking at you, you don't exist. And that when you sleep, you stop existing, but your mind continues to exist.
Whoa.
Yeah, and I was like, I don't think science bears that out.
It's like the double blind, the double slit experiment.
Oh, he told me about the double slit quantum eraser and all that, and I was like,
complete blind experiment.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, he was saying that the observer effect proves that quantum effects have, you know, a macroscopic something or other, and therefore, like, all effects are quantum, and that, you know, we are all basically in a big video game.
Damn.
And so if a god exists, according to him, it's that video game. And I'm like,
well, my dream in life is to not be observed, so...
Yeah, that was my dream, too.
Yeah.
Do you think God has cheat codes?
Cheat codes? Yeah, that's what the whole Bible was about, wasn't it?
No, I mean, like, for us.
Yeah, the 10 like... cheat codes.
Yeah, the ten cheat codes.
Yeah. Oh, you know what? That
Moses
me.
Brought down the tablets. Cheat code 1. Up, up, down, down.
Down, left, right, left, right. Right. PA start for infinite health.
Yeah.
Or to part water.
Yeah, that's how they walked for 40 days without dying or whatever.
Yeah, they had invulnerability on.
Yeah.
Wow. You know, it doesn't seem as impressive once you...
Yeah, you know, the whole parable of David and Goliath kind of loses its luster when you realize David just activated his ability.
He just ulted.
Yeah, he just used his ult. Like, what is this?
Yeah.
I mean, that's amazing. Who knew?
There probably is, like, a gamer-fied version of the Bible. Yeah, I know maybe we're getting a little sacrilegious here, but, like, I mean, I got you that gamer-fied pickup artist book.
Yeah, so I was going to mention, so I started reading it at work.
At work?
Yeah, at work. And boy, howdy.
It's had some really great results.
It's got some, it's really great.
For a bit of context, I saw somewhere on the internet someone post an excerpt from this, you know, pickup artist book on Amazon where they tried to really video gamerify it, but also the writing was just horrible and
The gist of it is that, the gist of it is, like, if you have no luck with women, it's because you're not using the skills you've developed as a gamer to, like, woo women. And so, like, every chapter starts with a cheat code and, like a legitimate, like, video game cheat code, and, like, half the each page, you'll be reading along and he'll be talking just some regular pickup artist shit. You know, some, like, dumb, like, borderline incel stuff, but not quite there. And then he'll just veer heavily into, like, it's just like when you're in Minecraft and a creeper's walking up to you sexily. And I'm like, dude, what are you talking about? What are you doing?
Now, everyone knows, like, when you're in Minecraft and a creeper walks up to you sexually. That happens frequently.
But my favorite part was I flipped to a random page, and then I Snapchatted this to Connor. I'm sure I can find the page again. But I flipped to a random page, and there's, like, a whole paragraph where, for some reason, he just veers completely off the topic of dating and video games to talk about how good a movie Step Brothers is.
It feels like a reference we'd do.
Yeah, because he's talking about, like, women will sometimes do this thing called a shit test. That's what he calls it. Where they'll say a thing that's obviously untrue to see if you'll call them on their shit. And I'm like, that's called a joke. That's just a thing people do that has nothing to do with being a woman. It has nothing to do with you being a man. It's just a thing. But
the situation, like, he writes out is about
stepbrothers,
about stepbrothers.
Yeah, like, you would think it would be like, he would say, like, Final Fantasy VII's a terrible game, and then you'd call her on that, and she'd be like, haha, you got me. And instead he's like, so let's just say she says that Step Brothers is a bad movie. Then you would say something like, we all know that Step Brothers is actually one of the greatest comedies of all time, and Will Ferrell and John C. Reilly, and it's like, what are you doing?
Like, the entire scene was about, like, Will Ferrell movies, right? Like, he starts it out with, like, imagine you and your girl are bonding over how funny Will Ferrell is, and
referencing his movies. And it's like, what is happening? And then, like,
already after you have a girlfriend.
Well, yeah, you're on date number 2 or whatever. I flipped to a random page halfway through the book, so maybe he gives us the key earlier on.
The master code.
Yeah, the cheat code. But the craziest thing to me is, like, I flipped to the very end of the book where he, like, gives the final bits of advice, and then there's, like, one extra page. I'm on the backside of the last page. He actually has a little bit more, and the little bit more is his story. And it's not, like, an about the author. It's from his perspective. And he's like, here's how I got to write this book. And what he writes is that he was with a girl for, like, 10 years, almost a decade. And the two of them were getting along really well, but he knew he was never going to ask her to marry. And she figured that out, and she left him. And he's like, well, you can only jerk people around for so long before they figure it out. And so then I used all the things that I learned from video games to write this book. And I'm like, what? So you had a long-term relationship, and then you made a mistake, realized you made a mistake, and learned all the wrong lessons from it?
Yeah, it's
then
like...
Then you wrote your fucking book about... What?
It's like, what? Like, you... You know, normally you'd expect, like, the pickup artist story of, like, oh, I couldn't get a girl at all until I did these things. But no, right. He had someone for, like, a
or
decade.
Or the opposite direction, where it's like, I was slaying mad pussy all over town... And here's my secret, right? Like, those are the two stories I was expecting. Instead, this one is just like a sad, like, I fucked up and I recognized that I fucked up. And then I wrote this unrelated book.
And filled it, like, with so much video game.
Should we name the book? I don't know if I want anybody to buy it.
Nah, I mean, we just... We just talked about all the humor we've so far gotten out of it.
Yeah, the other thing is my wife said that as long as I'm using techniques from the book, I'm allowed to cheat on her. that's the rule. Yeah. I can bring her in here to confirm if you'd like. But you can just trust me. That is the rule. And so, you know, for her channel, maybe I'll try some out. We'll film it and... Maybe, if I can work up the newt sack to do that, I don't think I will.
Newt sack as a service.
That would be useful.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Have you ever not had enough newt sack? Get more newt sack as a service.
I rarely have enough newt sack, but now that newt sack as a service exists, I can get newt sack anytime I need.
Get some balls delivered straight to your door.
Yeah.
Incredible. Thank you.
Uh-huh.
Thank you, Incetic Enterprises.
Uh-huh. Yeah, use code Incetic for 20% off balls delivered.
Your first ball delivery is half off. That means you're paying... You get an
by
extra...
That...
No, actually, you know what? For your first delivery of two balls, you get a third ball for free.
Oh my god.
Yeah,
that's how much we know you'll love it.
Yeah, and if you don't like them, you can just send back the two you paid for and keep the one you...
If you don't like it, then log off.
Excess stock, you know, sometimes we lose one ball and only one chips out, so it's basically spare parts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can get a discount newts.
I don't know. Yeah. Alright. So back to the game. Here at the end, the final pro challenge, I guess not the final one, but, you know, if you've been doing everything so far, is the spin speed upgrade. Well, spin and flip speed. So now suddenly you can, do more and go back to all of those media challenges or whatever where
you
just couldn't do enough to get, like, gold points, and now you can probably do, like, a double flip when you could only do one before, or
triple. Yeah, you can finally finish your incentive. Percent.
Yeah, and actually earlier we unlocked the final sled, which is the hang glider.
Oh, okay.
So like now you can just hang glide when you want to, and that's cool. And also here at the end, for example, we're gonna get the last build license. I haven't really again done anything with putting down objects, but I haven't done any build challenges, and I only have 100 build points. Well, here I'm gonna do the final one and therefore unlock the max thing. Like, you don't actually need to do the ones in between.
Good lord.
But yeah, then I'm gonna be able to put down, like, all the objects.
How many? What's the upper limit?
750 bill points.
Oh.
From 100 as a base.
They really jump you from 100, I guess?
Well, again,
100 is just to put, like, one or two good props down.
I have intentionally skipped all of the other build license challenges along the way.
Oh, okay.
So if you do all of them, you'd go probably from like 100 to 300, 500, 750.
Okay.
Yeah.
Whatever.
So yeah, it's just here at the Park Architect. So yeah, it's just here at DC Mountain Lab. you get kind of all of the culmination rewards.
I guess that makes you some kind of parkitect.
Yeah. I kind of wish they had said parkitect.
Yeah.
Missed opportunity there.
Yeah, really.
Yeah.
So, what's the... coin. Okay, I see.
Yeah. There's a money system in this game, by the way.
Okay.
Yeah. You used to buy, you know, clothes and...
But now that you have the one bus, you can put as many of them down as you can afford.
Right, right. You have to pay an initial fee the very first time you want to buy a bus.
Right.
But then past that.
Wow. Microtransactions? Okay. That was a good move.
Wow.
Haha, yeah.
I thought it would be funny to just make a noise of pain at the thought of microtransactions.
It wasn't as noteworthy an observation as I thought it would be. Not as original as I thought.
First person to have ever cracked that microtransactions are bad.
Yeah, turns out, guys, I have a feeling microtransactions are not what I want in my video games.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Personally, I like being able to play things in my game without having to pay extra money for them. I might be alone in that, though. I don't know. That may be an unpopular opinion.
Yeah, we'll see how the comments feel.
Yeah.
I will
say... Best score?
I will give the game credit for somehow... making the CIA pun that they needed in this game also a dig at Electronic Arts.
What did they do?
It was the CAI was a Colonitronic Arts Inc.
Oh, right.
Yeah. So, yeah. Bonus combo points for that.
Yeah, because they were like, fuck SSX. We hate those fools.
I'm trying to remember back then, and once again, I was just out of, most video game scenes, I'm sure they were bad for reasons, but I don't even remember, how bad was EA at 2005, you know?
Gosh, I have a hard enough time trying to put myself on a timeline.
Yeah, it's like over the last decade, you know, all the various different publishers have, you know, been notorious or infamous or bad for different reasons.
Yeah.
You know, right now, it's EA controls all the sports licenses, so that's why all, the Madden games and shit just sucks. But back in 2005, that wasn't the case. They'd have been bad for a different reason.
They were... I don't know if they were starting or if this was, getting close to the peak
I picked the most minuscule reason that EA is a bad company.
Yeah, I was wondering.
I know that. It was just the first thing that came to mind.
Yeah.
Musical finale, reward none.
Yeah, I guess we are wrapping it up. Well, I'm actually being paid by EA. We'll never know truly how bad.
So you're saying we blew a Surfshark sponsorship, but you are being paid by EA?
You are? Where's my money?
Or at least if I do enough good press for them, they might notice me and then pay
me. So that's not being paid. That's you simping for EA.
Right. I am working for them on my own in hopes of the experience.
Yeah, that's simping, right?
I don't know where this is going.
I want my money.
Dude.
That's what I want.
Whoa. Working for the Mafia was the original simping.
Oh, man.
I don't know.
Holy shit, dude.
Hey, Player One! Great job! And thanks for buying our game! Or thank your mom for us! For buying our game, I mean. Now we're almost done. Just one thing left to say. And if you don't like big musical finales, then just press A. Hey! Congratulations! You just beat the game! You're the greatest player ever! Insert name! If you didn't like it, well, it's really a shame. But if so, you should know this guy's to blame.
Hey, bro, remember your self-awareity and to never let Todd ride with you and me. Hey, Todd.
Now I know you're the player. I thank you for the favor. Thanks to the crew, I'm still a knuckle dragon slayer.
Guitar solo!
Oh.
but we must celebrate now that we've reached the end and thank him or her for playing our new special friend.
Oh, why am I the bad guy?
Well, you weren't exactly good.
I didn't steal or technically lie, I'm so,
so misunderstood.
This song is awesome! It's almost as awesome as the story that my cousin told me about this kid who was driving this car, and he was driving really fast, and he slammed on the brakes, and some paper flew out and cut his head right off!
But he didn't die, though.
Nah, yeah, he's alive today, walking.
Thank you, thank you, thank you for playing our game. We're sorry, sorry, sorry if the story was lame.
We hope you want to play it again.
But if you do, we're warning you, it'll be just the same.
Good game.
Wow.
Yeah.
Imagine if every game ended like that.
I gotta say, though, that final shot, as it panned out further and further and further, that did kind of make the pit of my stomach drop, like a sort of existential dread nightmare kind of
thing. You know,
I don't think that was the intended feel.
I know, but...
Well, you know, I actually get that same feeling from Google Earth. I used to be afraid of Google Earth for the longest time because of the way that it would, like, zoom in and out.
Oh.
Yeah, I mean, it's still, like, if you go somewhere out in the middle of the ocean, unlike Google Earth or such, like, I don't know, go to Hawaii.
There's Sandeep Karkar! There's our boy!
Zoom out more and more and more and more, and you just see the ocean, the never-ending ocean.
But, yeah.
Yeah, okay, here's some cool behind-the-scenes stuff.
I'm wondering how close to the point where they found out that they were for sure going to be out of money do you think they were when they made that end cutscene? Like, do you think this was made, like, afterwards or just before, or?
I mean...
Because I'm guessing the animation team was probably just given, like, all the stuff to animate pretty much all at once. You know, because they didn't have to animate almost any seriously important, like, story stuff, right? So, mostly it was just, like, stuff just before events and, like, some generic goofy jokes and stuff, right?
Yeah, I mean...
I like these pictures.
Yeah, those are all the, you know, men and women of Amped 3 loading screens that we didn't get because there's just so many in there, and we got most of the boring ones.
Yeah.
We didn't get to see our boy Sandeep Karkar.
Yeah, but he's in the credits, so.
Right.
Our boy. There's Jesse Jones, though.
Right.
Yeah. I wonder how close to them realizing they were running out of time to make this game, did they, stopped filming this behind-the-scenes footage.
Like, okay, we can't have anybody on behind-the-scenes duty. Like, we need everybody to be...
Also, it's like, this has suddenly become less silly where we can,
goof around.
Fight with pool noodles and hockey equipment.
Yeah.
We have a game to finish.
Here's the thing, the reason that they ran out of money is because of the pool noodles. Those were solid gold pool noodles, actually.
Oh my god, those must hurt to... Not just
they were heavy hit, and
not just be hit by, but
gotta
also
say,
like,
there's a person over there with a great name, Bronze Swallow. Excellent name.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Mike Chief Nusinov.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I mean, to your guys' points, I mean, it's the same sort of thing. I mean, you saw in, like, Neversoft's credit sequences in Tony Hawk games. Where
there's
it's
Havoc.
Like, hey, look at all the fun we're having, da da da. Also, we have to put out literally a game per year. And,
yeah.
You know.
Remember, snowmobile racing is dangerous.
Yeah, no. This is very weird. You get a disclaimer about snowmobile operation.
Snowboarding, snowboarding, completely safe. No one has ever even hurt themselves snowboarding.
Well, they figure you've played all the game, and you're probably at this point going like, I gotta get out there and see if it's for real.
Yeah.
That's what I imagine you as a child sounded like.
Dude, that was young and Sedic playing like SSX, and then again, you know, parents took the family over to some hill in Missouri where they would just shoot fake snow up onto it, and then... You know, when I finally got past the ski school or whatever, I rode, like, super fast into a ditch. Nice. Kind of cut myself up. Yeah.
Oh, here we go.
So yeah, back to the gameplay. Now that you have access to the hang glider, if you can get yourself off the ground, yeah, you can soar through the air, and it is pretty interesting. Might actually be, if I do decide to do a bonus video, might be the reason for it. Because the cheat codes overall are kind of... average, you know, unlock everything, all tracks, all music, all rewards.
Man, you're really going up there.
There is something for being able to hang glide and kind of possibly break some of the boundaries.
Imagine seeing that. Like, you're going snowboarding, you see somebody get a hang glide, you're like, oh shit, someone's gonna hang glide, all right. And you see them go,
they just
help,
go
help,
away.
Then they're gone.
They're just gone.
They're like, did you see that golden man just fly away? Was that Kid Rock?
It's just Kid Rock begging for help as he is ascends.
Damn it.
To escape our digital simulation.
I mean, I guess I gotta say, rest in peace, Kid Rock.
Wow.
Yeah.
I can't believe you killed him.
Rest in Rock, I guess.
Yeah.
Whoa. Rear.
Rear.
Nah, it doesn't feel the same.
It's not the same, yeah. So what's the cheat codes? What you got? Is that next video, maybe?
That's again, maybe I'll do a bonus video, because there is, like, one quite interesting cheat code that allows you to explore around. I'll just leave it at that. Again, most of them are just kind of, you know, give yourself all music, all da-da-da, well, you know, fresh save, but... yeah, we'll have to see, but that has been Amped 3, at least the main levels and main story and such, so thank you all for watching.